Act 5, Scene 2, the most crucial scene, the last scene. Desdemona is asleep on her bed. Othello says he will not shed her blood, but she must die, else she'll betray more men. Now here Othello is totally convinced that Desdemona has betrayed him, and he says that I cannot kill her, I cannot shed her blood, I cannot do that, because the heart of hearts, Othello loves her, but he feels that she must die. Otherwise, she is going to betray more men because she has not been faithful to me, and she is going to betray others too. He kisses her and she wakes up. When he kisses her, she wakes up. He tells her to pray because I would not kill thy unprepared spirit. Now, he tells her that please pray. I want you to be mentally prepared that you are going to be killed, and urges her to confess that she gave the handkerchief to Cassio. And he says that please tell me. What did you do? Did you give the handkerchief to Cassio? She replies, no, by my life and my soul. So she replies very authentically, very sincerely, no, not by my life and soul. But he refuses to believe her. Othello is like so poisoned against her that he refuses to believe her. She pleads for her life, but he suffocates her. Now she pleads that don't kill me, but he suffocates her. He hears Emilia calling him and lets her in. She tells him that Cassio killed Rodrigo and that Cassio lives. Now Emilia comes and she tells him that Cassio has killed Rodrigo and that Cassio is still alive. Emilia hears Desdemona calling out and finds her just as she dies. Meanwhile, Desdemona calls out to Emilia. Emilia goes in and she finds Desdemona in a state just before she dies. Othello confesses, it was I that killed her, adding, she was false as water. And thy husband knew it all. Now, he tells Emilia that I have killed her because she was not true to me. And I came to know about everything. So, I had to kill her. Emilia is shocked at her husband's involvement. May his pernicious soul rot half a grain a day. He lied to the heart. She yells for help. Monteno, Graciano, and Iago rush in. Emilia's confronts Iago. Here, Emilia comes to know about the villainy of her own husband, and she realizes how he has misused her and how much a villain he is, and she yells for help. So everybody comes inside, including Iago. As soon as Iago comes, Emilia confronts him, who admits he told Othello that Desdemona was unfaithful with Cassio and tries to stop her talking. Now here they both discuss, but then he says that you keep quiet, and he tells everything to her, but he says, asks Emilia to keep quiet. She says, I am bound to speak. My mistress here lies murdered in her bed. Now, she says, I have to speak because my mistress is dead and I need to tell everyone. Othello defends himself, saying, it's painful, and yet Iago knows that she with Cassio had the act of shame 1,000 times committed. And Othello here tries to defend himself by saying that, yes, Iago is also a witness, and he knows that Desdemona and Cassio were in a relationship, and says he saw his handkerchief in Cassio's hand. And he says that I've even seen the handkerchief which I gave to her in Cassio's hand. Emilia says, O thou dull moor, that handkerchief thou speakest, of it I found my fortune and did give my husband. She says, oh my God, that handkerchief I found and I gave it to my husband. Finally, Othello realizes the truth. Iago stabs Emilia and runs away. Then Othello finally finds that it was Iago who had killed, who had played all the mischief. But Iago stabs Emilia and he runs away. Monteno runs after him. Lodovico, Monteno and Cassio come in with Iago as a prisoner. They all run, go and catch hold of Iago and bring him as a prisoner. Othello asks, will you, I pray, demand that demi-devil why he had thus ensnared my soul and body? Now Othello asks Iago, will you please tell me, why did you do something like this? You made me kill my own wife. Iago says, from this time forth, I never will speak a word. But they piece together what has happened from letters found in Rodrigo's possession. Othello is arrested. Now, slowly, everything falls into place and they all come to know about the villainy of Othello. Lodovico tells Othello, your power and your command is taken off and Cassio rules in Cyprus. Now they tell Othello that when Othello is arrested, they say that Everything is now in the hand of Cassio and he is going to rule Cyprus. But before they can take him away, Othello asks that they speak of one that loved not wisely but too well and threw a pearl away richer than all his tribe. Now Othello realizes what he had done and he is extremely sorry about it. Then he stabs himself, kisses Desdemona and dies.